Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is an e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Quickly, and he will be able to fix it more efficiently, correct? So whenever it is a defect, try to give as much as possible information to your developer so that he can quickly locate the error and then he can fix it quickly. Okay. Clear everybody why we are giving so much of information to him? Yes, to help him. Okay. Okay. You should be a, you know, friend with your developer. Okay. Usually what happens, the developer and then the tester always, you know, it is like one and east and west they will be. But you should maintain a good rapport with your developer. That's important. Okay. Fine. Now I have given maximum details that are possible. In case it is possible, please also attach the screenshot. Okay. Attach the screenshot so that anything observation which you have missed, he might observe that in the screenshot. Correct. And what is that screenshot? It is very simple. You press the print screen button on your keyboard. It is after the F12. Functional key on your keyboard. Okay. Press that F12. Okay. And then you got to go to the paint over here and then paste it like this. This is nothing but we call it as a screenshot. Okay. Take the screenshot of the defect and then save that. Go to this one and then save it with some name, with preferably the defect ID. Okay. Let's say the defect ID is some 45 or something. So you can save it with the defect ID, click on the save, and then what you do later, here you try to attach that defect. Okay. Go to the attachments over here and attach the screenshot of that defect. Don't you think it is going to help him more? Correct. Maybe you have missed some observation, but he might observe it in the screenshot. Sure, Anita, I can go slow. Okay. Did you understand why we have to attach the screenshot? Sure. See here. What I got to do is, do you see the print screen button on your keyboard? Everybody, do you see the print screen button or not? It is after your functional keys. On the first line of your keyboard, after the functional, it says PRTSC system requirement. Print screen button, everybody finds it? See, it is simple. Click on the print screen button, okay, and then go to the paint, Microsoft Paint. Everybody knows the paint, right? Okay, so it will be in your accessories. Oh, where is it? Okay, it will be present in your, one second. So if you go to the programs, accessories over here, and then do you see there is Microsoft Paint, correct? Yeah, you can use Word also, Vidya, no problem. Okay, so you paste the defect like this. Actually, I'm using the console, right? So it will not show you properly. Okay, it will not show the here properly, but I can put it here if you want. So see here, I got to paste like this. And then go ahead and save this one. Save it with, you know, some defect ID. Let's say this is defect ID 45. You save it with certain defect ID. Okay. All right. And then after you save it, it will be appearing somewhere on your desktop or somewhere. And then you got to go here. Okay, do you see the attachment here? Click on this attach. I will just select anyone. Okay, there is some file over here, but you have to take the image file and then click on this open. You do the attachment to your email, right, in the same way, and it will get attached. Okay. Vidya, it is better if you attach. Means I'm telling you, right, like the more and more information you provide to the developer, he is more comfortable in identifying the defects. Okay. Again, Vinita, see, it is simple, Vinita. I'll write the steps for you here. Because there are like team viewer and the two things, right? So you might not be able to see it. Okay. See, what you got to do, press the print screen button from your keyboard. Okay. I'm writing the steps for you. Okay. Then, open Paint. Or you can also take some Word document, MS Word document, and then paste it there. Then save it. So your defect is ready. Okay. And then what you do, go to the attachment over here. Okay. Which you can see in the defect module. Then click on that attach pin. Okay. Click on that. After you click on that, do you attach in your emails? How do you attach? The window browser opens. You select the file and then you click on the attach, or you double click it. Correct? Okay. Yeah, that is it. You know, so simple it is. Do you attach the attachments to your email or not? In the same way, okay? Click on this pin over here. Okay. And then this is opening the Windows browser. You can select any file that you want to attach. You can double click or click on open. It will get attached. Simple, right? Yes, Raji, you can do the, I mean, it is a paint, right? You can mark anything. You can do anything on that. Okay. Okay. See, you want me to tell this? Okay, see here. If you want to write anything, you can write here. See, some defect. Okay, so this you have to explore. Okay, now don't expect me to teach the Microsoft Paint here in QA class. Then all other students will take me out of the class. Okay, so you can mention that, okay, this is a defect, or some, you can write like this. Okay, Raji, is it clear? Or you have so many options over here. You can have the text and then where is it? Home. Okay, so do you see here we have certain certain boxes over here. You have the brushes. You can write something. Okay. You can highlight the defect and you can send it to him. Okay. Okay, Raji, is that clear? Okay. Yeah, Jyoti, you can take the screenshot of the defect and you can attach it here. And then click on the submit. So defect number 49 is successfully added. Okay, so this is how we create the defect. Clear everyone how to create a defect? Yes, Vinaya, I can see your message. I'll read the messages one by one. Okay, give me some time. Is it clear how we create the defect, everybody? It's not that difficult also. Go to the new defect over here in the defect module and select the ones and then write the defect. Okay, the one more thing, regression, I think we missed it, right? Regression means what? Now, we are trying to do the functional testing over here. Okay? So, for the functional testing, we need not mark regression. We will mark it as no. In case we are doing the regression testing, then we will mark it as regression testing. Okay? Once more. Okay. See, it is quite simple. Go to the defect module here. Then write the summary. Anita, this is not hard. Okay, come on. Don't say this is hard. Always you say it is hard. Okay. So account summary, this is not working. The transactions are not getting displayed. You write it here. Okay. Yes, And then you can say here assign to, you got to assign it to the developer. Let's say Alice is our developer. Select the category here. This is a defect, so select it. Select the version, whichever you want. Okay. Estimated fix time, plan closing version. This your developer will enter. Leave it blank. Select the project. Is it reproducible? Yes. This is a new defect. Select the browser. Detected by Alex. Then detected on date. Then we have the language. Set the priority. How quickly your client wants the release. Let's say it is high priority. You can put it as high. Is it the regression testing? If you are doing regression testing, put it as yes. Otherwise, no. Okay. Severity. How much it is affecting the system? Not very much. Subject, you can choose here. We are, you know, testing for the Bank of America application. Click on OK. And then in the description, you got to mention the precondition and then the step, expected outcome, actual outcome or the defect, right? Then go to the attachment over here. You can select any file in which you have pasted, okay? You can write the defect over here. I mean, you can attach the defect. Is that clear? It is very simple, okay? Compared to requirement, test plan, test lab, defect is the most simplest one. Correct? Okay. Okay. So now we are done with the requirement, test plan, test lab and the defect. Okay. Now you tell me if you have any doubts. No, Anita, if you log in as Alex, okay, one by one, slowly. If you log in as, you know, Alex, then it will be appearing as Alex. If you are logging in as Anita, it will show Anita. Okay. Okay, wait. Let me note down over here. Whoever wants help, I will note down. And whoever has questions, you can ask. Okay, slowly, one by one, we will go. Okay, Pavni, you need help. Fine. Okay. Do you get these defects from the test lab? Okay, see Vidya, what we do in the test lab, we do the execution. So there we decide whether it is pass or fail, whether it is a defect or not. When we see the defect there, we should come to the defect module and then we should report the defect in the defect module. Okay, then Rushali, test plan is confusing. Okay, you want the test plan again. Fine. Then you want the test lab briefly again. Sure. What next? Okay, Abdul, I have sent the recordings, right? The previous batch one. You refer to that one now. I'm trying to upload, but it is taking lot of time. So I have already sent you the, you know, recordings for this quality center. Go through them. Okay. They are the same things. The topics are going to be the same, right? Okay. Vinita, you have a question in the test lab. Tell me, what is your question? Okay, Rushali, you are getting confused between the test plan and test lab. Okay. I'll explain that. Okay, what else? Okay, sure, Ratika, I have noted down. Test lab, test plan. Anything other than these, you tell me. Any other questions other than these? Okay, Shukla, fail cases are treated as defect. Exactly, that is right. Okay, sure, Jofi. Anita, test plan is confusing. Very good, Anita. Okay, requirements also. Okay, Bharti, you want the requirement also? Okay, so I have to repeat the entire session. Okay. Okay, Reshma, ALM. Sure. When I hit submit button, it is saying workflow error. Okay, Pavni, that I need to check, okay? Let me log into your computer and check. Can you show the flow from requirement once? Just a brief flow. Sure, Preeti. Anyways, all of them have got reported here. I should show them. Test plan is creating test case. Yes. How to connect the requirement test plan? I will show that, Sri, once.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.